we are painting indoors, not outdoors, and we are painting a live bird. We're bringing a bird into the room with us. You can either take photos, sketch, paint, whatever you like, but you bring, they have tables and chairs, but you'll bring your own supplies. And this is in, we're meeting there in Largo on Tuesdays at the Narrows. We've got the Waltham, just before you get over the intercoastal waterway to on the north side of the intercoastal waterway at Waltham.
Is this inside?
Inside at the McGowan Nature Park at the Narrows. And we've been doing it for the last two Tuesdays, and we have a couple more Tuesdays. Next week we're going to ask for these little small falcons. They're quite unique.
Very small.
What are they?
Big ones, but they're little.
What is it?
The falcons.
And if we don't get them, then we have owls. It's a home for injured raptors. And definitely, they just stop by there. We had a screech owl.
Carol, so
we're meeting there every Tuesday in February from 10 o'clock till noon. And if you could give them a little donation when we and it is a city-owned facility. But it's very rare. It's a teaching facility, one of the only ones in the southeast. So these birds are allowed to be out, and we, the public, can handle them with some training. But the little ones, we can handle them with very little training. You can get a glove and walk up to the park with a screech owl.
Oh, Jules.
For free.
That's the Largo Library.
No, it's at the Largo. It's off of Almerton goes to the beach. Almerton turns into Walsingham, and just before you hit the water of the intercoastal, it's on the north hand side.
What's it called?
The Narrows.
There's a sign right there.
It's 146th Street turning to the north, and it's called Hamlin turning to the south. But we turn north.
Every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday in February, we are there. Our plan air group, we ask if we go inside. You can just do it. Just take pictures if you like.
Yes.
And an owl may or may not close, but it's amazing. It's
amazing. Okay. Now we have, I don't know, some of you are new, so you don't know about this. We have, there's another group of artists that meet out at Crystal Beach. It's called the Crystal Beach Art Group. And they meet on the last Tuesday of the month. It is a group of about 20, 25 members. We've done some changing, and we are going to start to be a painting group. So starting as of 9:30 in the morning, we'll get there, we set up tables, and we paint together. And we critique each other, we give suggestions, we just have a chance to sit down and paint together. Bring our brown bag lunches, eat. Someone throws in the eating dessert. And then we'll have a little critique afterwards and discuss whether we think, now that Carol's given us this great lecture on is the painting done, now we'll be able to look at each other's painting and say, yeah, we think that painting's done for you, or we'd suggest something else. So anyone is invited to come along. If you want to join, it is $20 a year for membership.
And this is at Crystal Beach?
Crystal Beach at the community center.
And a show.
And we do two shows. Art. We do two shows at Crystal Beach called Crystal Beach Art in the Park. We'll do one March the 25th. If you are a member, it's free. If you're not a member, it's $25. And then we'll do another one. We're doing another one in November. I don't remember the exact date on that one. But I will let everyone know when those are getting close.
March
yes,
25th,
Carol.
Before the day before our next Art in the Park, right?
No, Art in the Park is the second Sunday of the month.
Yeah.
Yes, Carol.
This is at the end of Saturday.
Also for the plein air, if you want to paint outdoors, starting in March, we usually do 2 months at a time, depending on where we are. We'll be at the Florida Botanical Gardens. And that's at around 9:30 in the morning. Florida Botanical Gardens
Hamptons are in Largo off of Old Walden Hamptons.
Tuesday?
On Tuesdays.
That's a fun area.
Always Tuesdays, and it's, we meet around 9:30. You can come at the gardens at 7 in the morning, they open at 7. And we'll be there for 2 months, March and April. And we usually meet up where there's a patio with lots of the restrooms near the wedding garden. Just to say hello, make sure we know where each of us are.
Okay. Thanks.
Top of the World Art Guild is having their annual show March the 5th in their clubhouse. I don't know if any of you have ever been to Top of the World, but it's a great, big, huge condo complex, and they have great artists there. I'll be in the show. It's on Sunday the 5th from 12 to 3 in the main clubhouse. You can't miss it when you drive in the place. And I am going to have a one-day workshop on the rock wire wrapping jewelry at my studio. I have room for just 6 people. All supplies are and materials and tools are included in the price. If you're interested, put your name and phone number and I'll call you and tell you more about it. Thank you.
Okay. I'm going to start the show and tell because I'm at the end of the table here. I know most of you know that I do alcoholics, and I got creative once, and I brought the unique style where I actually I started folding the paper, and I love what happens when you fold the paper, and every time I fold the paper, I get a little different design, and I love to go in and look at all the different shapes, kind of draws you in. So I started making some small tiles. All I have left of the first batch of those are the black ones. Don't ask me why I have black ones. I've had therapists buy these because they make great Rorschach kind of tests. That's what I say to everyone, what do you see? That's how I start my conversations with customers. So and then if I turn it upside down, it's a different picture. So that's what's neat about it. Well, I started out doing the gluing the paper that I painted directly from the tiles. Then I got creative and I had a tape piece that I made a kaleidoscope out of it. And no one ever really looked at it, so I decided, okay, put it on 4 tiles, cut it up. And so I'm selling it as a trivette / coasters, Tyler, whatever you want to use them. They're polyurethane. So I really started with the gluing down. Then I started taking paintings and cutting them apart and exploring. I got some block tiles closed out at Home Depot and decided to put the paintings on to let the black show us so it makes it look like it's a frame and a picture. At our Crystal Beach art group that we met on the last Tuesday of the month I got to finally start painting alcohol ink directly on the tiles. It is a whole different experience, and I have to finish these off, but I had so much fun exploring something new. That's what it's all about. It's even if you go, you're bringing something to work on, and someone else is doing something different, you might think, okay, I'm going to try something different this time. So it's all about learning and growing and engaging one another and inspiring each other. So inspire your friends and your other artists and get inspired by yourself. So these are my new creations, my alcohol ink on the tile. Carol, you're next. You want to talk about your jewelry?
I didn't know that we're getting up and
talking about
show and tell. Well, you already were all so sweet, and you came up and you looked and you told me lovely things, and I thank you all. And this is my hobby. I'm really a painter, and that's how I got in this club, because we originally were just a painter's club, but now we've expanded it to arts and crafts. I'm now doing also collages with pieces of wood and branches and stones and seashells and sort of, I got
woodsy. What are you calling this? What is this called?
I'm calling this my urban rustic. Something or other. This necklace is all made from red oak twigs and bark.
Really?
And a few medallions. And the right colors.
Looks like stone.
And this is a river rock that I found in the Russian River when I was visiting my grandson. And of course, a lot of you know about wrapping, and there's several people here that, where's Nora? Nora does a beautiful, oh, there she is. So that's what this is all about. I'm so happy Pam said to me, bring some of the new stuff. And I really have never done the show and tell here before. But already I got a couple people signed up for my workshop. So if anybody's interested, there they are, they're raring to go. And there's another one. And you'll make the basic stuff, and it'll open the door to your own style and your own way. You have to see Nora's display at Art in the Park, and you'll see how she expanded in her own direction. So, thank you.
Who has their stuff on the table? Who has stuff on the table? One of you guys, whoever, Carol. Why don't you come up and hold it up?
I was listening to a podcast, an art podcast, and there's an illustrator an artist that was talking about a very fast oil painting technique used by illustrators. And I thought that I would bring in an example of it in case you, as artists, aren't familiar with a very fast oil painting technique. Newspaper artists then have to get a picture done in 2 hours and have it so that they can take a photo of it. So I thought I'd just bring in an older one.
No, I already have a ticket.
It's hard to see here. I'm not sure if you're able to see. This is a St. Pete Times, an older picture.
Can't hear you.
I'm sorry. I don't know if you can see this, but in the St. Pete Times, portraits were done. It looks as if, I don't know if you can see this, but it looks as if they're like watercolor.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. But for an illustrator, it has to be done in 2 hours. And no, it's not at all in watercolor. It's color pencil on illustration.
Who's got their phone going over there?
Go outside.
For if you hear anyone saying they are an illustrator or working with the newspaper, now they're using computers, but I'd like you to know that the technique is very fast. It looks as if it's a watercolor. It looks as if these artists have spent hours on it, and they do not. This was done by Rossi Newson, the St. Pete Times at the time. He was one of the main illustrators, and I took two classes with him at the St. Pete College. Actually, it was with Melissa Miller Niece. She invited the St. Pete artist into the class in an illustration class at the college, and he showed us the technique, made us do an assignment. We brought back our assignment, and he liked my work so well, he actually gave me his original. This is his original, and it's on illustration board. They do, of course, they have overhead projector, but it's colored pencil on illustration board, and then just a little bit of matte media, which is like an Elmer's glue that goes on top of the colored pencil, and then with Q-tip or a rag, you put in the oil, the skin color, and you wipe it away. You wipe away all the detail. It has to be like a matte board.
Is it a hot press or a cold press?
It wouldn't matter. It wouldn't matter because if you're doing it for permanent, you gesso it. But for an illustrator, he doesn't even worry if it's going to last. And he said this may not last very long. This is back in the late 90s, and it still lasts. And so for my homework assignment, he was so thrilled that he gave it to me. I did colored pencil underneath, and then it's hard to believe that this is that fast. I drew a picture of my grandmother, put in all kinds of fine, fine detail. If you can come up sometime before you leave to look at all the details.
I'll believe all this artwork so people come up.
You can see the zipper because it's colored pencil. You just draw it in. You can see the buttons or the pins that she had. She's Hungarian and American. So she's got, I put a flag, a pin that's an American, and then her Hungarian flag. Once the colored pencil is on, you smear it on. Looks like Elmer's glue, but it's matte medium.
And then you actually put the skin color on with, I use the Q-tip. You just smear it on.
What kind of paint do you use for that?
Oil.
Did you gesso the paper?
Now this one I did not. Because the lesson was not.
Okay.
So then then after Melissa Miller-Niece gave another workshop, Pat Morrison and I took it over at the Museum of Fine Arts. And that one, she said, if you want to keep it, then gesso the mat board or illustration board. So I did the same thing just for a little self-portrait. And all the details, all the colors pretty much are done in, believe it or not, colored pencil. And then you just come with a thick, either a rag or your hand with a glove, and you just put the oil in. And it's done.
That's amazing.
That is done. It's a very fast illustration oil technique.
So how long does it take the oil to dry on top?
On top? It's very, very thin.
So it dries pretty fast?
It dries pretty fast.
Are you talking about linseed oil, or are you talking about
oil
like
paint?
Okay, so what? You would use like a yellow oxide? Or?
You just use straight tube. In fact, when we did this, you just used your illustration board, his little tape. He showed many samples of his original front page illustrations. Mm-hmm. He just would take, to get a fine line, he'd just take masking tape and make it so nice, a nice edge.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And then he would just pick like a raw sienna or some color that would be for the skin color. Mm-hmm. And over the whole, after the matte medium was put on, it's like a plastic, it's protected. Then he would just smear it on. Completely cover it, and then he'd just wipe it away with Q-tip to show the shape.
Just one color, the flesh color?
For this, he just used the flesh color. Yeah.
What about the other shapes?
Some of these he used acrylic, and then he actually used colored pencil on top.
That matches the drawing.
Yeah.
Oh, so once he's done the colored pencil first.
Yeah. Yes. And then
would you do a demo for us?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you getting
that's a good idea.
Yeah.
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 I don't know if you want to take a picture.
Very demo.
I'll leave this up here so you can take a look.
Do you have any workshops for this?
Melissa Miller-Niece offers them regularly, so over at the Museum of Fine Arts. So we'll see. I could.
Why don't you do one?
Are you interested in doing the demonstration for us? Or just who's our new program director? $75. Okay.
Yes, if you wanna.
Okay, we're gonna try. We'll try to schedule her for next season.
Do a demo.
Okay. Do a demo. Who's got artwork next? Jim.
You guys know I've been working in acrylics forever and ever. Actually, forever and ever. I checked back in 1968 when I first started painting in acrylics. So that means I'm coming up on 50 years.
Wow.
I've always looked for another medium, but I tried water-soluble oils, but they dry. I like something that's going to dry quickly. I came across a different medium. Anybody know what encaustic is?
Mm-hmm.
Wax?
Donna does
encaustic. Encaustic wax? Okay, working with hot wax? No. This is tube encaustic. This is water-soluble encaustic. It is beeswax and pigment. And this was, I did this one in about 15 minutes just to see what the heck it was like. And when I was all done, it was dry. And what you do to heat set, so it dries like acrylic, but if you make a mistake, you just take a wet something or other and wipe it away.
Nice.
It's erasable.
Yes, that's nice.
Now if you want it to set forever and ever, you take a hair dryer and just move it back and forth across this, or put it in a 200-degree oven.
Would you be wanting to give us a demonstration?
Yeah, what about a demo on that?
Okay, yeah.
I have not experimented.
We're talking about next year.
I have not experimented with this fully, but I got to tell you, this is really fun because first of all, it doesn't fall, it falls into the other category. I mean, acrylic gets lumped in with oils and they're entirely different media, but it's always lumped together. But this acts like acrylic and it falls into the other category, so you're going to compete against all kinds of other things, but it looks like acrylic.
Okay, Jim, so what do you call it again? Heat.
Encaustic.
It's called encaustic.
I've never heard that.
How much is it a tube?
Now, I will tell you, this just came across the pond here a while back. As far as I can tell, 2014 was the first time it was developed and brought into the United States. It actually comes from Spain.
Where did you buy it?
And the brand name is Ceni, C-E-N-I, Ceni. And I bought it from, and this is up here, Miles Conrad Encaustics in Tucson, Arizona. You can get the information up here. This ain't cheap right now. My guess is this is going to be very popular because of the fact that it is wax. It's beeswax with pigment in it.
On your palette, does it dry quickly?
Wait.
It's like acrylic. You got to keep it sprayed.
Okay, water will keep it moist.
What happens if you get caught in a rainstorm?
It washes away. It's like what? It's going to wash away like your water.
Unless you baked it.
And you don't want to leave them in a hot car either.
Correct. Well, you don't leave the tubes in a hot car.
No.
What?
Oh, no.
This you leave in a hot car. Because it'll set up for you automatically. Anybody wants to come on? I mean, really, this is beautiful. I've not seen a medium to me that's so versatile. Now, a couple of things with regard to this. Any water-soluble works, which means if you have water-soluble oils, you can work on this as well. If you have water-soluble acrylics, which is all acrylics, you can work with acrylics. In other words, any other medium you can mix in with this. And heat set it the same way as you would heat set beeswax. Now, the interesting thing is, this is 2,000-year-old art. This goes back to the Romans.
Does Blick sell that? Blick, Dick Blick?
No, Blick does not sell it. Neither does Jerry's, neither does any of the other ones. It's so new, and I was cruising looking for some other type of encaustic. I'd love to do encaustics with the waxes and so forth. You can build this up really thick layers, just the same as you could with regular encaustics.
Do they have a selection of colors, like oils?
It's getting wider, but they got about 40 colors.
Did you just use your four colors there, Jim?
Yeah, they actually came with six. I only brought four came with six colors.
Oh, you got a kit.
That was a kit for $60. And they're basically 2 ounce tubes. Okay, and it's kind of interesting to work with.
How much were they for the six? $60
for the kit. Which is not bad because if you change, look at the high prices of the high quality acrylics there in that price range. Anyway, I thought you guys might be interested in it. I'm going to experiment with it.
Could you email me your link to that so I put it in the brush fire?
Sure.
Who's next on the table?
There's a portfolio here.
Oh, okay.
This is one of our new members. She's going to show us sampling of what she does.
And I guess I could talk about, since everybody's talking about something new that they're doing, I've been at watercolors for about 30 years, and I decided I wanted to do something different, and I've done years of life drawing, figure, and that sort of thing. And so anyway, I decided I wanted to get into pastels. And because I've done mixed media with acrylics and all that sort of thing. And anyway, in this figure drawing class, it's not really a class, it's open drawing with no instructor. Melissa Miller-Nisi is also there, and she's painting next to me. And she uses the Pan Pastels. And which is, I don't know how new it is, but it seems to be gaining popularity. So I wanted to try that. So I ordered Pan Pastels, and this is my first portrait
that I did with the pan pastels, and which is, you know, a lot different than watercolor, but it's a whole lot of fun, and the pastels go on very smooth.
What is the difference between pan pastels and a regular? Saying P-A-N?
P-A-N pastels, yeah. The pastels are very smooth, and they're in little round containers, and they actually have a palette that you put they're like little plastic containers, and you put them in the palette, and you use their applicators that have little sponges on the end, and so you apply the pastel.
Oh, you almost paint with the pastel.
It's your painting with the pastel.
They almost remind you of eyeshadow cases.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're no dust. They're very light powder. They're more almost like creamy, and they're wonderful because they go on so smoothly. These are a couple of more that I had done. And but anyway, I love the pan pastels. They work beautifully on the pastel paper. You can also use the pastels to tint. I've tinted white paper. You know, with the sponges that come with them, and you tint the paper yourself, and then do your.
One was from Thursday night. Thursday night.
I was going to get back to it. Not this last Thursday.
The Hale Center.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. This is one I was working on, and I never got back to it. But I threw it in here because I didn't know I was going to be staying up here doing this. I thought I was just going to bring something in the show, then I really do something. You know, I said, oh, put it up on the show and tell. And then this is something that I had done in charcoal. And this, I did this with, it's kind of a different way of doing pastel pencil. And so this was actually just done with the pastel pencil. And then back here, let's see. This is kind of awkward. I guess I should have stood this up, but I didn't. And just a little bit of something I do that's, you know, a little more on the abstract side. I do nudes. Who doesn't do nudes? Well, anyway, I've got a couple of those, again, just working in the charcoals. And this is on newspaper print paper, so anybody who draws is familiar with that. And then in the back, all of my watercolors that I still own are framed, but I had taken some photos of some of my watercolors. And this one had been for a fundraiser to the American Cancer Society. That was a beach scene. But these are just some things that I threw in the back that shows something more.
Thank you so much for showing up. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Absolutely.
And where did you get your pan pastels? Do you just look online at, like, Jerry's or something?
I ordered from two places. I ordered from Amazon, and I also ordered online from Dick Blick's. And you would be able to find a lot of the stuff at Dick Blick's over in Tampa, but online for sure. You know, they have, you know, everything there. So a lot of it I got from Dick Blick's.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Okay. For the tell part, I wanted to be able to tell you that we have 5 sales at Marguerite's in the last 2 months that we just changed over. So John Belda, he sold 1, Lynn Rattray sold 2, and Renee Cicero sold 2 shell sculptures. John, I think yours was acrylic, correct? And Lynn, I don't know if she's here.
She's not here.
I don't remember what her...
she does animals and things like
that. Yeah, I don't remember what hers was. My sign-up sheet for Marguerite's for the next spot is on that far table that's vacant there with the green sheet. Next fall's sheets will not be put out until our meeting in September. So I started out as a watercolorist, and I did a lot of my framing, you know, cutting mats and doing frames and acrylics, and I've gotten really sick and tired. And I don't know about you guys, whether those of you who were here and saw that demo on putting your watercolors on canvas. I have started doing some of that, and this is one of the small ones that I've done. So it's watercolor on canvas, and it's all nicely sealed. and you can just put it up that way, no problem with fingerprints.
How do you seal it?
I forgot about that.
Yeah, I know, I remembered my notes from the demo, and I did it, and it is sealed. This one, I may have grabbed, I thought I had grabbed a mat, but I can see on the certain parts in the leaves, it's picked up a shine. But you have to do at least four coats.
Is it a shellac or a varnish?
Pardon me?
Shellac, varnish,
matte medium? I adhere with matte medium for the watercolor and canvas. And then the acrylic spray, and a clear acrylic spray over top to start with. And you definitely want to weight those, and you want to leave them overnight. I have done other weird little things in trying not this. This is an acrylic board, and I did not have a frame that would fit it, and I just didn't want it that dinky. So I have Barilla glued that onto a regular canvas, and then I have used my spackle from doing wallboard. And so you can, and I've been experimenting with other things. I've been adhering, I do watercolor on Yupo, so I've been adhering some my watercolor on Yupo onto canvas as well. And I think I brought that in September to show. So I've been doing some of that kind of thing. I took advantage of our lovely club and the tar gel demo that I missed, and I watched it on YouTube, and I didn't have any tar gel, so I experimented with glues. And this one is glue that's managed to be raised enough, so if somebody around, like my husband, and when he sees me start doing stuff, and he sees me picking up something from the garage, and he says, "You can't use that." Yes, you can. Yes, you can. So, just, you know, as I said, I've been playing with a lot of little weird stuff, and hope to keep doing it. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else bring things to show? Sure. Yes, we are done. Thank you all for bringing things. Thank you all for staying to listen. I think we inspired one another. So have a wonderful day.